in God's house today. Amen. We're not open at this point with a word of prayer, and we get right into our praise and worship. Lord, we thank you for today, and we thank you for the opportunity we have to be here in your house, Lord. And Lord, we are thankful for the nation that we live in, the freedom we have to be here and do this here today, Lord. Lord, we welcome your Holy Spirit here with us today to guide, to minister, to direct, to be our teacher. And Lord, it is our desire that our hearts would be open, prepared, and ready to receive all you desire to pour into us today. We thank you for all those things in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen.
here to work.
addiction, but over all the junk in this world, it was all nailed to the cross. Jesus took not just our sin, but he took the shroud. He took all the stuff that goes with it. The word actually tells us he made a public spectacle of it. And that sometimes we have to be reminded that that's already defeated foe. Now that we don't have to fight against the junk in life. I know sometimes it feels like we do. You know, the only fight we have, the only response we really have to have when the garbage of life comes is to pull up your word and say, this already says you've been defeated, so I don't know what you're doing here. When sickness and disease comes, when devastation, whatever comes in life, you just have to remind it what Jesus already did. You got a right to be here because of what Jesus did. You don't have to try to fight it. You don't have to fight something that's already been defeated. It's been defeated already. Now, I know that it's difficult for us to do that. We don't see it with our natural eyes, and the enemy knows we tend to be guided by what we can see in the natural. But it's been done in the spirit, and that's a much higher realm than what we can see with our natural eyes. But to connect what Jesus did in the spirit, and as I say every week, we connect what he's done in the spirit, we connect our faith to what he's done, we see it then come to pass in the natural. Right, those things have to come into line. We come into a true agreement with what God's word says, that there's nothing that can stand against us. Nothing. Thank you, Lord. And I want to ask our prayer partners to come forward and to be available right now. And if you would like prayer for anything, we're here to agree on God's word over that situation in your life. So we just spend a few minutes doing that. If you'd like to just spend a moment in worship in your seat or at the altar, whatever you'd like to do, just take a few moments right now and allow you the opportunity to do that. Thank you. And goes on to tell us, Lord, that when we know you've heard us, then we know we have the things we've asked for. So Lord, as we've brought our petitions to you, we prayed according to what your word says, we know that we have, because we haven't come asking if you will do. As we come in agreement with what your word says, we're coming in agreement with what you have done. We've come in agreement with the completed work of Christ and what he's already accomplished. As Lord, as we do so, we expect to see it come to pass in the natural. Even if we haven't yet seen it with the natural eyes, we know it's done in the spirit. So we can give you thanks. We can give you praise for it before we've even seen it. We just do thank you for it in the name of Jesus. And everybody said, amen. Amen. Good Lord, amen. I want you to take a real quick moment, turn around, shake once again. Let me know you're better in church this morning. Jesus says in John 10:10, the enemy comes, but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. So when you have those things going on in your life, that's where it's coming from. We know where to give credit. But then Jesus goes on to say this. He says, but I come that you have life, and have life more abundant. And we believe that putting Christ at the center of our life leads to abundance in every part of our lives. You know, he cares about all aspects of your life, your home, and your health, and your family, your finances, your job, your business, whatever you have. If you put Christ at the center of it, he will bring a more abundant life to that. So we're on a journey together, learning, and we're growing to those things together. We invite you to be part of it with us. We're also a church that believes that you should be able to come to church and be who you are and not feel like you have to become something to come to church. Amen? That it isn't that all of us don't have some stuff that needs to be changed, right? We all got our list of stuff that needs to be changed and things that we ought to be doing a better job at. But what I know is this, is the Holy Spirit is the one who can bring that change to our lives. No amount of band-aid rules and silly things are gonna change those things in us. It is leading you to the Holy Spirit to do his work in you. And I can attest to things in my life that I was made to try to change so many things in my life over the years that it never worked. But just getting a hold of the Holy Spirit, letting him do work in my life, has just changed my life drastically. I know it has been in you as well. So we're just leading you to the one who can bring the change to your life that you need. Amen. If you are new, we actually ask everyone to fill a connection card out for us each week. So if you didn't get one of those cards on the way in, if you put your hand up, we actually should get those one of those cards to you. If you're new, you can just give us as much information as you're comfortable giving us. A matter of fact, this box is on there that says if you don't want us to contact you, we won't contact you. The back side of that card is really the important part to me. You'll see there's areas, there's boxes you can check off to ask specific questions or get involved with certain things here at the church. But really the most important thing to me on those cards is prayer requests. Pastor Tammy and I pray over those each week. We have a prayer team that prays throughout the week over those. So you know you have a church family that's lifting you up, that's praying for you, supporting you. Jesus said his Father's house is to be a house of prayer, and that's what we want it to be. Amen? You can turn those cards in as you're leaving service today. Our ushers will be at the doors as you're walking out. You can drop them off of them on your way out. If you happen to miss one of them, you can drop it off at the information counter in the foyer as well. And if you are new, I'd love to meet you after service and shake your hand, get to know you a little, answer any questions that you might have. And let's see, the next thing I want to do now is to dismiss our youth to their service. And now it is time to receive this morning's offering. Let's praise God for a moment.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
The power of God is great, isn't it?
Amen.
We're all here because we know the power of God exists. We know it moves in our lives, and we need Him every single day. We all go through trials and heavy burdens. This week I was woken up and the Lord told me to read Matthew 11:28, which talks about those heavy burdens, to lay them down at His feet. And that's what we do when we come to church. We lay those heavy thoughts down for freedom, because it's those thoughts that keep us from enjoying God's promises. So when we come to church, we give our tithes and we give in our offerings because we pay homage to the Lord for being so good to us. So we leave this house knowing that we'll be restored, that everything that the enemy has taken from us will be brought back to us. Everything the enemy takes, we take back, because we're emboldened by the power of God and the Holy Spirit resides in us. So we just lay down our heads today and we put those tithes and offerings into effect for the promises of God to take forth in all the world, not just this church. So we bow our heads. Heavenly Father, in the name of Christ Jesus, we thank You as we come to Your holy house to pay homage to You, Father, to spread Your word, to spread Your love across this nation. Lord, that it changes the hearts and minds of people, and we thank You. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen.